Good morning, class.
Good morning.
Good morning. Sit down. Do you remember what we had done in our previous class?
Yes, I do.
What are the things we had done? Who can recapitulate one by one? One by one? Yes.
Auntie, we talked about the Neolithic Revolution and the pit house.
We talked about the Neolithic Revolution and the pit house. Where did we find the pit house?
Auntie, it was Burzum.
Where is Burzum?
Auntie, present day Kashmir.
Present day Kashmir.
And it was built under the ground.
Why?
Auntie, because the animals, normally if they built at the top, animals, they could hunt them easily.
Okay.
But under, they could not see where the entrance is for them to enter and kill the person.
All right, and also inside the earth there would be
it will be cool
during
winters, summer,
and during winters it would be
warm.
All right, so they would be comfortable. That's the reason why they built the pit houses. Now, one question had come up. Somebody has asked that what would happen if it rained. What do you think they did if it rained? Yes.
How did they move from there?
They moved away from there. All right. So by this time, we had also done something which was, there was a new word that you had learned starting with C.
That's a very interesting word. One boy had learned it.
The intelligence is also called? What is it called? All right, I give the next letter, C O.
Prosom.
Cognitive. So man had not developed his cognitive skill of building a roof over the pit house. Right? Or possibly he had done it and he had suffocated to death. Possibly, I don't know. Maybe. So he had to, right? So therefore, yeah. So we do not know why he did not build that roof. But he did not build it. And during rains, we know that he shifted from. Now, in this map. Can you see the map over there, children? There is this place called Mehergarh. Can you find that?
Yes. Yes,
It's Mehergarh is on this side. Can you find this side? Can you find this? This is Pakistan, right? On the borders of Pakistan and Afghanistan, and it is near a pass which is called the Bolan Pass. All right, you may have done this in geography. It is called the Bolan Pass, right? Now, the earliest village settlement was found at Mehergarh. So the first village or in the world, in the entire world, where man settled down. So when he settled down, he developed a village, people. All right. So the first village is found at Mehergarh. Can you find here?
Yes.
All right. The first village. All right. Now, if we can go to... No. How can you go to the... Go to slide... please do it. No, do it next. Can you see? All right. So now, in the villages, when the excavations were happening, you know who do the excavations? What are they called?
Archaeologists.
Who are archaeologists?
Artifacts. Who dig up artifacts from the ground?
They dig up, right? And they find out. They try to reconstruct the history of that period, right?
My grandmother used to have one. She has it now.
Many houses may have this.
Yes.
You know, what do you call in Hindi? This one, what do you call in Hindi? This one?
Charka.
Hamandista. Kootne wala ha hamandista, right? And this is a silbatta.
Yes, auntie.
Right? Correct. Coconut chutney with that. All right. So, archaeologists, you know, when they found from Mehergarh, when they were digging, they found, and what is this used for then?
Auntie, to make, we have got hurt, so to make the waste of the,
of herbs.
It does not stick properly, so they grind it out.
All right. So, the archaeologists found this, not this, and something like this, right? And they were confused as to what was this purpose of the stones. So when they went to the all over India, they discovered that in various places we still use, in the south they use this to make a paste for idli and dosa.
Yes.
Am I clear? Huh? Yeah, have you seen that?
Yeah.
In many of the houses it's very, very heavy.
Very less we find that.
Yeah.
And because the
mixies have come in.
Because of the weight of stone.
Yes, exactly. It's very difficult to lift. This is also the various types of mortars and pestles that they had found.
That was made for medicines.
The smaller ones are made for medicines. And if your grandmother does not have, she eats pan, and if she does not have teeth, then she usually crushes the beetle leaf, and you will find it over there, right? These are made of different. I'm showing these because these are very modern things. Those were the earliest one, right? Now, yeah, but we are not going to do the tools right now. We are going to do the these houses. Can you find, this is a house of Mehergarh? All right, can you see the structure? Is it very different from the houses that we have today?
Yes, auntie.
There are the rooms. No. How is it different?
There
were no, the house had a roof. Huh. Yes?
Auntie, they are different because normally we have a second floor, third floor, and we have doors and all. But there they have animal skin doors. They
all right.
Like that. So, and there are four rooms, mostly four rooms.
Mm-hmm.
So, they only have one place to sleep and others for other purposes.
You are not wrong, but write down the layout of the house is almost the same as today.
Yes.
There is a basic wall and then there are chambers, right? Now, this could be a kitchen because you see, this could be a kitchen because there's something over here, and this could be the bathroom, this could be the places where. So, it's very similar to the rooms that we have. This is a reconstruction of a house that was done at Mehergarh. Remember Mehergarh?
Yes.
The first village, right? This is the reconstruction that the houses could be like this, right? These are the layouts of the houses of the villages.
They didn't have halls.
Did you see? There are no empty spaces. They all are together. All right. So now Mehergarh is near the Afghanistan-Pakistan border, and it is famous for the first village of the world has been found over there. Am I clear?
Then we
have, pardon?
Huh?
They grew wheat and barley. So what did they cultivate when they settled down? What did they cultivate?
Crops.
What type of crops?
Wheat and barley.
Yes.
Auntie, but I have a doubt.
What is the doubt?
Auntie, how could they find that it is a wheat? They grew wheat and barley, but when they started agriculture, they had wheat and barley. But when the archaeologists found that they used to grow wheat and barley, so how will they find when the insects in the ground will eat them all? Most of them will be eaten by the insects.
Hmm.
So how will they find out that the wheat and barley were the main...
They developed this? That also understood or developed ways and means of protecting their crops from the wild animals, also from the goats who would, remember, they started domestication. They used to have sheep and goat and cows, and right, so they would eat up. So they devised ways and means of protecting their also. I don't know how many of you know of it or not, that many of the houses in the villages, they don't, for their little kitchen garden, they do not spray pesticides.
No, they don't.
What do they do then?
Auntie, they would grow.
How would they protect this thing from insects, as you said? How would they protect?
Auntie, they used to put it
All right, so what they did is they did sprinkle water. In the bucket, they would mix red chili powder.
These are the spices.
Not all spices, and also turmeric in equal quantities. They would make a mix and then spray it on the this thing. The second one was, the second one is that, you know, they used to cook, make a chulha, an angethi. Have you seen that? Coal and woods and the those are used for burning it. So that ash they would sprinkle on the plants. Am I clear? That protected it from insects. Did you understand? So there were no insecticides or pesticides during that time. But,
You said the masala, like red chili powder, and auntie, then only I remember that my grandmother, she used to sprinkle turmeric outside our house because ants, they used to just come inside our house. So
it is,
she just sprinkled everywhere turmeric.
All right.
Then after just one day, everything will be no answer, nothing.
Correct. Did you understand now? So they developed that intelligence of understanding, of developing, of knowing what to do to protect their crops. Sit down. Very good. Right? All right. Now the villages have come up and the, all the people are now living in villages. Right? So every village is different from the other village?
Yes.
Yes? Why is it different?
Auntie, because...
Alright, so if you are talking of resources, chalo, thikai, I take into account that the resources may be different in different villages. The people of the villages are also different, na? Yes?
Yeah, I think because of the features, and because some villages were in the plains and some were in the mountains. So, Adi, what could they do in the mountains, they do there, and what the people in the
plains could do? Alright, so they dressed and decorated themselves, yeah. And even the food was different, so they were. Now these villages, just, yeah, you want to ask a question?
No, auntie,
answer. Okay, yes.
Auntie, you know, the inventions which they found made them different from others. Like the, in one place they had found the wheel, and one place they had found the metal knife. Not now, the stand, but the metal knife which they found earlier.
All right, sit down. So what happened is, very good. The villagers, right? They formed something, I don't know whether you know of this word.
Tribes.
So our ancient India was divided into very small tribes. Each tribe had its... Each tribe would be...
Hunter, a gatherer.
Each tribe would have a...
Position.
Who would...
A head.
Or a leader. It would have a leader. Or now this position of a head or a leader was not permanent. And it was not hereditary. So anybody who was powerful, who could take, give protection to the tribe, became a leader. Did you understand? Keep this in mind because you will need it when we are doing the Mahajanpadas later on. Am I clear? Keep this in mind. So each tribe had a head or a leader. Was the position of the tribe or the leader hereditary? Position, was it hereditary?
No.
The position was not hereditary. What do you mean by hereditary? That the position goes on to the son after the father. Am I clear?
It goes to the heir.
Am I clear? Hereditary. Am I clear? All right. So then who became the leader? Anybody who was physically strong
and was very intelligent,
could give protection to the tribe, became a leader. All right. So each of the tribe was different. Each tribe was different. Right. Now the thing is, can the archaeologists find out in what ways were the tribes different? Could the archaeologists find out?
No.
No, they could not. They are going to build the history based on the material remains.
Yes,
on the material remains. On the artifacts that you are finding. So now that they are different, that they have a different culture, that, you know, how, who finds that out? What is the name of this person? He is known as an anthropologist. All right, this is also a science in which they study about the development of culture of various tribes. Am I clear? So you will find that if we see the next, and I've purposely put in a number of tribes, the reason being I wanted to show the diversity that was present in our country. Okay, so now see the diversity. Where do you think they belong to?
Assam.
Maybe, or the northeast. The northeast. This could be central or any part of this thing, right? And this again is northeast. This is from Gujarat. This is from Gujarat. Right? Okay. Yeah. And this again is from, this is from South India. This is from Ladakh. She is from somewhere, Gujarat or Mewar. This one is South India. Clear? And she is from Kutch. She is from, I don't know. And these are all again from different parts, right? So what it means is, and can you see that they have all dressed up differently?
Yes, sir.
They have decorated themselves differently. Why? Is because? Every tribe is different. They have a different culture. They all have different cultures. Do you understand? So now we go back to the question. I think you have it in your civics that there is unity in diversity.
Yes.
That
yes.
India is a very diverse. The reason why India is diverse is because of, there is a reason. It's large. Did you understand? The culture, and hence the culture is also very diverse. Am I clear?
Yes.
Yes, did you understand? So the first village that we found was?
Mehergarh.
We found, we saw the houses also in Mehergarh, and the villagers, they formed tribes, they had developed a culture of their own, and each culture, and I have shown you a number of slides in which you saw that every person, every tribe had its own way of dressing up and decorating themselves. We have seen that? Yes? All right. Now, can we see, last time I could not show you some of the tools of the Neolithic and Paleolithic. Can we go back and see that?
Yes.
Huh? Okay. Yeah. So this is the Paleolithic tools.
Stone tools.
Yeah, tools. Can you see how big these were, right? Even the base was, what do you think? Was it heavy or was it light? Was it light? Or was it heavy?
It was light plus even some tools were heavy for different purposes.
Do you think, I'm just pointing this out, do you think this tool or this tool is light? It should be heavy. They all look very heavy. Compare this to these. Compare them to these.
Mm-hmm. And the one which is over here is more heavy due to its huge size of the body.
Which one? These?
Yes, auntie. The tallest one.
This one?
Yes,
it was not heavy, that's what I'm trying to say. Can you find these tools have more shape?
Yes.
As compared to these tools? Can you find that?
Yes.
Do they have a shape, a particular shape? No. They tried it, but then? They did not, right?
And the pebble tools.
Huh?
Pebble
tools will be for Neolithic or for Paleolithic? It will be for Neolithic, right? Now, these are also some of the tools that we have found from the Neolithic. What do you think these could be used for?
Farming.
Yeah. Which were the ones which could be used for farming? This one? This one?
And the one at the bottom.
All right. Huh? But can you see these are very basic ones. They have tied it with rope or the roots or the thing of some trees. Am I clear? All right. It goes on to show that they are still in the stage of learning. Okay. All right. Yes, you were asking something. Somebody raise a hand over here. Okay. All right. Remember we said that with the use of wheel, they were making pottery.
Yes.
Not spinning wheel, pottery wheel, the potter's wheel. The making pottery, and they were using the pottery for cooking, for storing food. Very good. For storage purposes. These are some of the potteries of the Neolithic period. This is from China. All right. And this is just something. Am I clear? Can you see that? Right. Now, interestingly, this is also Neolithic tool, a pottery. Am I clear? But can you see it is broken?
Yes, I'm clear.
Why?
Auntie, there's a material which is used to harden it from outside and inside. Auntie, it's like a paint type thing, but it hardens the after it dries. It becomes very solid, hard. So anything which holds to it becomes hard. Like cement thing now. If we put it in rocks to join them, they'll join easily. And like that only at that age they had something like cement.
This is, you know, archaeologists, they have two ways of excavation. You know what excavation means? What is excavation?
Digging
the earth for artifacts, right? Now they use two ways of excavation. One is called vertical and one is horizontal. Under what you understand vertical?
Yes.
What is the meaning of vertical?
Straight line.
Suppose this is an earth and I start, you know, excavating this.
And the table is horizontal.
Wait, right? Suppose I start, you know, removing the earth from here and slowly so I'm doing vertical excavation. Am I clear? Now, if I start from this place to this place and in layers, if I remove the soil and then take the artifact.
And like in the mountains?
Huh?
Mountains, you dig like making a tunnel.
Huh, no, not making a tunnel. Suppose this is the piece of land where we have found that there are artifacts. There are two ways, vertical. Are you following? There's two ways. I can dig it. I can start breaking from here and then I can try to find out something from here. What will I do then if I'm doing it vertically? What will happen to the artifact if there is an artifact pinned over here? What will happen?
Auntie, you will not know where
it will have a crack.
Now do you realize why there are cracks?
Yes.
Did you understand? So they were digging it vertically and hence they did not know the artifact was here. So they broke the artifact. Could be what you are saying also, that over a period of time it may have broken on its own. Now if I am to retain that artifact, because retaining an artifact is important, right? It can't be broken. So if I remove layer after layer after layer and then take out the artifact as a whole from the earth, will I get a total artifact? Right? So all other artifacts that you saw possibly was done through horizontal excavation. And the ones that are broken, many a times there are broken artifacts also that we find, but many a times artifacts get broken because of the vertical excavation. Am I clear? Did all of you understand this? All right. Okay. Now, so we have done the potteries, we have done tribes, we have done about the houses and at Mehergarh. Now, Mehergarh is also famous, you know. If we are to find out whether there is class difference, you understand what class difference is? What is class difference? Rich and poor, right? So how are we to find out whether there were rich people? We don't know who lived in that Mehergarh village. Did the rich people live? Were there poor people? How do we know? Most of the things were made of clay. Some of the things were decorated, right? Now tell me, how are we to know whether they were rich people or poor people?
The material they used to build several things.
They make a stencil by
mud or by the joining stones and heating them.
All right, have you heard of this ruler, this pharaoh, this Egyptian pharaoh called Tutankhamun?
No,
Yes, yes, yes.
You have heard?
Yes, I have heard.
All right. Why is he famous all over the world?
Auntie, because auntie, he had a very, the materials which he had were very rarely found in that time.
He was in a casket. The mummy of that pharaoh was in a casket which was made of gold.
Yes,
and in that chamber, gold and silver and precious stones were in abundance. Right? So therefore, historians believe that he was possibly, it is, he's the richest pharaoh, king who had been buried. Right? So, in the ancient, we do not live in the ancient times, na? Nobody lives. Right? So how are we to find out the class distinction of the ancient times? We can find it through
burials.
How? Let me show you something. I don't know why this has not come out. No, it's not there, right? So, burials. What are burials, children? After the death, the person is buried, right? Now, when the person is buried, the ancient people believed that you have to keep something along with him. Why? Because he may need it in his afterlife. Do you understand? The Egyptians did it. No, even the Harappans did it.
And they used to put the bodies in lines with lime,
To preserve it. That's mummification. But then along with that, they would also keep, you know, in China and in other places, the cat and all other such animals, which if the person, whatever he used in his lifetime was also buried. Now, yes.
Auntie, can I just repeat
this? Yes, please.
Auntie, in September 1991, two German tourists, Helmut and Eric, found a well-preserved dead body of a man who lived about 50 years ago. He was discovered in a glacier of Oxtel Alps near the border between Australia and Italy. He has been nicknamed Odds, the Iceman, after the valley of his discovery. The body has been extensively examined and x-rayed, measured and dated. Analysis of Odd's tooth enamel shows that he spent his childhood near the present village of Elthrums, Italy. He had
Italy. It's not Italy. Italy.
57 tattoos, some which were located on or near Ulster points. Scientists believe that these tattoos indicated the an early type of the skull.
Acupuncture.
Items found with him included a copper axe with a mule's handle, a flint bladed knife with an ash handle, and a quiver.
Quiver is the one where you keep the arrows. You have bows and there's something to keep the arrows. That's quiver.
Arrows with vibranium and a dog.
Good. I got your point. Now tell me why he died and in a glacier the body was found in
the
glacier. Because of the photo.
So what is your larger point?
Auntie, the larger I mean that the people who were there before, they because of the evolution, the winters. In winters, they found out that the people were buried them all in that area. But after they moved from there, it became winter and the snow in that, they were found in the mountain area. So the snow covered him fully.
Fully. Or it could be that by accident also he may have been buried.
Yeah, that's also most chances of his burial.
Yes, right? He may be accidentally buried in that snow. But I am talking of burials. Burials is when a person dies, you dig up the earth, you put the person inside the earth, and then you put the artifacts around. So when you put the artifacts, based on the artifacts that you put, you can understand whether the person was rich or poor. Because a poor person, there will be very little artifacts, or the artifacts made of clay would be put, but a rich person may have many things put along with the dead body, which he may have needed. In one of the burials in Harappa, the woman is wearing some bangles and all of that. Alright, so therefore it just shows that there is a possibility they believe that there is life after death, and they may need these things in their afterlife. And so they did it, yes?
Burial was here.
Yes.
There's the snow beside it, and there's the line.
Yes. Alright, so did you understand this thing, children? All of you?
Yes.
Any questions now? No questions? No questions? So now what have we done today? Can you just revise? What have we done today? So let me, who are archaeologists? Who are archaeologists? Who excavate? What are the two types that they take? Vertical and horizontal. Which is much more safer? Why is it much more safer? Because you remove layers of the earth and then you excavate that artifact, right? And this, there is every chance of the artifact breaking. All right. Then we have done, why is Mehrgarh famous? First village. Did we see the houses?
Yes.
So if the people lived in villages, what did they slowly turn into? They were agriculturalists, they were farmers. But they formed, the villagers formed what? The villagers formed tribes. Now each tribe had a
head
or a leader. Was that post hereditary?
No.
Why?
Because they would give their honor to their son.
No. Why was the position of the head and the leader not hereditary? Why did they not keep it head? Why is it that after the father could be the leader, a very good leader, but why did they not allow the correct. So the person who could give, possibly the son was not that
worthy
of it. Very good. Worthy of the position. So therefore they did not make the position of the leader hereditary. Then we have done about who tells us about the culture, the probable culture of
anthropologists.
Clear? Then we had also done the burials, and through burials, what do we know? What do we come to know through burials?
That they believed in life after
that. They believed in life after that. They believed it?
Caste.
Not caste. We do not know about caste.
And if the tribe was rich or poor?
Tribe was rich or poor? Poor in the tribe. The people in the tribes were rich or poor. So the burials tell us about
class,
not caste, class. Clear? Okay? Alright, so what is the homework you will do? First, write down a few questions. Why was the position of the leader, not hereditary in a tribe? Very good question. Who decides that this person is worthy of becoming a... Who decides? Which people?
Are the leader who was before?
No.
Suppose the leader does not want to stay or dies, suddenly dies. Now who decides that there should be the next leader? Which people? The tribes and the elders of the tribes. So India had a very democratic setup from the very beginning. Alright, so the villagers actually chose, and or the elders of the village, they selected the most worthy person on in their tribe to become the leader. Am I clear? Write another question, children. Who became the leader of the tribe? Why was the position of the leader not hereditary? Of the leader, not hereditary. And the second question that you have to do, how do burials, the spelling is here, how do burials tell us about class? How do burials tell us about class difference? Us about class difference. All right, and I want you to do these in your copy. All right, and give it for correction. Thank you, children.